So I'm going to be talking about some recent developments in Haskell tooling, particularly editor tooling and documentation generation and so on. So haskell-ide-engine was a project started in 2015. It's supposed to provide a consolidation of effort of all the people, different people working on Haskell editor tooling and things like that, and also provides an a uniform way for editors to talk to programs that provide intelligence about Haskell source. So, and also it aims to provide an extensible framework. So, if you want to write your own tools that provide information about Haskell source, it's easy to integrate it into into editors and already existing workflows. So, a brief history: in 2015, Alan Zimmerman and some other people started this thing, but then they tried to build their own protocol for editors to communicate to haskell-ide-engine, which kind of fizzled out and things didn't really work out. So in 2016-17, Microsoft came up with this thing called the language server protocol, which provides a uniform protocol so that editors can talk to code intelligence tooling, and this is cross language. So how the protocol basically works is you have all these languages on one side and all these editors on the other side. So if you want to use JavaScript auto completion or diagnostics or things like that in Vim, you need to write a JavaScript plugin in Vim, another for Atom, another for VS Code, another for Emacs, and across all editors. So there are basically, for each language, there has to be a plugin for each editor. So what the language server protocol does is it provides a standardized set of features that your tooling can provide, and all the editors just have to write a plugin that can understand this protocol, and your language server will work with all the editors that have a language server plugin. So this provides, this turns an M cross N problem into an N plus M problem. So instead of writing N cross M different tools, you just write, the people who know about tooling can write tooling, and people who know about editors and writing editor plugins, they can write their editor plugins, and it'll all work together. So I don't think we'll have time for questions in the end. So if you have questions, just raise your hand, and I'll try to answer them. So in June 2017, I started a HSOC project to add LSP to HIE, and that went pretty well, and HIE gained lots of traction. And this year also, there was another GSOC project working on HIE, and by Luke Lau, and he also extended it quite a bit. So it has all these features. You can go to definition, find references, completion. I'll just show you an example. This is HIE running in VS Code, and this VS Code is talking via a plugin to the HIE executable. The HIE executable will work across any editor you want. So if you have some other editor like Emacs or Vim or whatever, as long as you have an LSP plugin and you can tell it where to find the HIE executable, it'll give you all these features in your favorite editor. So, for example, on hovering, we have documentation, and this comes from Haddock, and you can click on stuff and it'll open it up inline, exactly the documentation page. You can, this is exactly the documentation for your project. So you don't have to worry about versions and stuff. HIE handles all of that for you. You can also look at the source of stuff. So the source of from list with is opened up. You can, when you click on stuff, it'll highlight usages. So this, if you want to find out where this access is defined or used, it highlights where it's used in this color, and in another color it highlights where it's defined. So this works with any kind of symbol in your project. So it also has things like auto completion and quick fixes. Let's say this is actually the code for Hoogle, which is another Haskell tool which is also integrated into HIE. So if I say foo equals put str hello world, so this bracket is redundant. So Hoogle, so I get a warning here, redundant bracket, and hopefully somehow it should have popped up. It's not here. Yeah. So I can do these kinds of code transformations and stuff. I can map is imported here, so if I want to see what function map defines, what functions are exported by map, I just type map dot and I have all the functions in the map module with the documentation, the type, and so on. So this is basically an intro to Hi. You can look at the GitHub for more features that we support. And this is across editors, so it should work with your favorite editor as long as it implements, it has a plugin for the LSP protocol. Yeah. So we use ghcid. How many people use ghcid? Have used ghcid here? Yeah. And so ghcid has two parts. Now it's being split into two parts. One is the executable, which used to be what you use to interact with ghcid. And there's ghcid, the library, which sets up the ghcid session for us, resolves all the dependencies and where to find them, and just hands Hi a working ghcid session so Hi can talk to ghcid and give you all your features. So Hi also has an extensible plugin architecture. It's pretty easy to write plugins if you want to hook into already existing functionality. If you want to provide more quick fixes or more kinds of diagnostics, over here we have two kinds of diagnostics exist right now. Diagnostics from hlint, which provides general linting, and we also have regular ghcid diagnostics. So if I say foo equals 1 plus a, it'll give me a type error. Yeah, it says no instance for num car. Car isn't a number, so that kind of stuff. And even if your code doesn't, this code doesn't compile, but even then, if I hover over this stuff, I still have all the features. So even in this version of the code that is not compiling, Hi remembers the last version of the code that compiled and tries to use information from that to give you information about all your code right now. So it's still functioning pretty well. It's not broken, even though this code isn't compiling. Yeah. So, and it also correlates positions in your new document. So if I write some gibberish here, you'll notice that over here, I still, even though that line shifted, I still get the correct documentation for this symbol here, because Hi keeps track of how the changes come in and which, whether this thing is actually in the old document and how the positions correlate, and it'll give you the information from the old version of document that actually did compile. So this is an overview of how it works. This is the client, which is VS Code. When you type something, it sends a document did change notification to Hi. Hi processes that, updates its view of what it knows your code to be, and it invokes all the plugins that generate diagnostics and so on. It returns those, and then the client gives you, asks for more stuff if you click on something, if you want to go to a definition and so on. Like if you want to go to the right names definition. So, yeah. If you wanna, you can navigate, and you can just control click, and you will jump to the definition of wherever the thing is defined, and so on. These kind of features, these are, the client makes a request. I want to know the definition of symbol at this location, and Hi tries to figure it out and just respond. So this is basically the workflow between the editor and Hi. And writing Hi plugins is pretty simple. You just have to populate this kind of data structure where you provide your plugin name and description and stuff like that. And if you want to provide, if you want to hook into existing features, like you want to provide code actions like the removing the bracket thing and stuff like that, you can add one something here and it'll automatically surface those when the user clicks on those. If you want to provide more kinds of diagnostics, more information when people hover on a symbol, so on. So that kind of stuff, you can easily extend it. Alan Zimmerman recently gave a talk at Haskell Exchange, if you want to know more about writing plugins for Hi and stuff. So that he delved into more details and how you can do that. So this summer I worked on a project on getting ghcid to output something called .hie files. If you've compiled Haskell, you know that ghcid generates .hi files from your source, which contain information about your code, and so that ghcid can resolve it. So now the problem is, how many of you have used Haddock? So when you use Haddock and you enable, when you say enable documentation equals true or whatever, and you try to compile your code while in your workflow, if you on your project, if you enable documentation, what you'll see, cabal or stack or whatever will say building your project, then building documentation, and it basically, you'll notice that it doubles your compile times pretty much, because Haddock needs to compile all your source all over again just to know well about what ghcid already knows about. Like when ghcid compiles your source, it resolves all the names, it knows the types of everything, and it knows where the docs are and so on. But Haddock needs to repeat all that work just so it can generate docs for you, and it basically doubles your compile time. So what HIE files allow is, allow for tooling all the information that ghcid collects while it's compiling the code. If you enable an option called fwrite-hie, that has been just been merged into ghcid a few days ago, so you'll see it in ghcid 8.8, hopefully. So if you enable that option, you'll see a new file next to your HIE files called .hie files. So these contain different kinds of information about your source, so that tooling can read that instead of asking ghcid to compile everything once more, so that it can tell you about your code. So, and even if you have dependencies and so on, HIE currently cannot give you cannot tell you where this from integral, for example, is being used in your dependencies and so on. So what HIE files will allow you to do is scan all your dependency tree for .hie files. It can collate all your dependencies together and present you, okay, this function is being used in all of these places. And that is future work that remains to be done, but it's quite possible using HIE files. You don't need to invoke ghcid on anything. You just need to read the HIE file, and it can generate all of that stuff for you. So this is the stuff that is available in HIE files. We have a resolved name, so all it resolves all the names, so that name shadowing, and if you have two names that are the same, but they're not actually they look the same, but they're not actually the same, all that resolving is done by ghcid. It has to do that to compile your code. So all that it puts into HIE files, which name do you actually mean when you say map? Is it map from set? Is it map from list? So on. And the type of all sub-expressions and expressions in your source, that is also available. And the types of every identifier in your source. And also we try to calculate scope information. Anytime symbol is defined, we try to calculate exactly the precise scope, where in your text is this symbol in scope. So that can be useful for things like completion. Like you can know exactly which functions are, or which symbols are in scope at a particular point in your source. You can get smart completion that takes into account local definitions and local declarations and so on. So, and it also includes the original source. So if, let's say you work on something and it doesn't compile, and then you close HIE or whatever, you close your editor, and you come back to it another day. Now the code doesn't compile. So when HIE asks ghcid to give it info about this code, ghcid will say, I can't do anything, that your code doesn't compile. I can't tell you anything about the code because it doesn't compile. But if you have a HIE file on your system from the time it last compiled, tooling can make use of that HIE file to still give you information about your source. So I have extended hyperlink source, if you've ever used Haddock, with type information. So this is docs hyperlink source for ghcid. So if I hover over something, you'll see I get the type right there. So this is all generated from HIE files. And now this summer, another person, Simon Jacoby, worked on a project called HiHaddock, which puts all these doc strings into .hi files. So to generate all of your Haddock docs, both hyperlink source and the doc page, you don't need to invoke ghcid again. All the information required is in your .hi files and .hie files. So that makes it a lot faster and less bug prone. Like, that still hasn't been implemented, but it's now possible. So in by 8.8, you should hopefully see these features. So now if you see, if I hover over, say, something with a parametric with a polymorphic type, it'll give me both the types of the specialized type, how you're using it at this position, and also the type, the generic type, the actual type of new IOR, which is the polymorphic type. So you get to see both the original type and the specialized instantiation at this point. And we also like this ixr, if I highlight, this is not really visible I think, but if I hover over a variable, it's all highlighted, and precisely those, it's not text based highlighting. Like if you have three places in your source code, but they're different foos, it'll not highlight all of them, it'll highlight precisely the foo which is in the same equivalence class as the variable you are hovering over. So that kind of stuff. This HIE files contain a lot more info, and I don't really know JavaScript and so on. So if anyone has any ideas on how to put scope information and references data in these hyperlink source files, please contact me, or we can improve this a lot. So we're not taking all advantage of all the information in HIE files to generate hyperlink source, but it's possible. And in the future, we hope to see integration of HIE files in different tools like Haddock. There's already a pull request open, which should be merged pretty soon. And also, haskell-ide-engine I'll try to extend it to take advantage of the .hie files. If you're interested in helping out in any of this, like contributions are welcome. We generally, if you're on IRC on Freenode, the hashtag #haskell-ide-engine. If you want to help out, you can just sign on there and ask Alan or me or Lukla or someone about what you can do to help. And ghcid is the front end is dying, is being retired, and it'll become a library. Daniel Grober, the person who's maintaining ghcid, he's rewriting it so that it can become a lot more reliable and support new build. And we do support, we have some limited extent of support for new build projects in haskell-ide-engine, but it's still kind of iffy because it keeps changing, and new build is still under development, so it keeps changing and so on. So it's not that reliable. So ghcid is being rewritten to use source plugins, I believe, so that all of the issues with different build tools, cabal, stack, mix, all of them can be resolved. So that's a work in progress. Alan is working on incremental compilation, which is as you're typing, ghc will try to compile as much as it can. Even if your code has an error or something, you'll just stub out those portions. If you're interested in that, talk to Alan. Again, he's there on #haskell-ide-engine if you want to speak to him. And recently, a few weeks ago, there's been a new development called the language server index format, which is made by the LSP guys, which is basically a file, lsif.json, that lives in your work tree that contains cached information about all the LSP requests and so on. So it's mostly useful for dependencies and things that don't change that much, static files. So instead, if you look over here, I can't jump to the definition of this because the source may not even be available right now. Because when stack or whatever builds, say byte string, it doesn't keep the source around for HIE to be able to access it and show you the definition and so on. Or even if I want to use where is this ds.length function used in all my dependencies, that is not possible right now. But HIE files and language server index format is basically a way to solve that. It contains information about all your source tree, including dependencies and all, in a single file. So plugins can directly read that file instead of going through a language server like haskell-ide-engine. So you don't need to have any executable running, so memory issues are solved. You just read that file and you get all this information about your source. So that will be useful for dependencies and so on. And it should be a very easy task to translate the information in HIE files to this language server index format, because they contain mostly the same kinds of information. So these are a few links to if you want to install or try out HI, you can check it out here. This is the language server protocol, and there is a time for questions.